Hello there. In this audio extract from our Introduction to the Key Skills session, Dr. Tim Zylstra discusses critical thinking at university. If you find this helpful, we have more useful workshop extracts on our YouTube channel, Derby Uni Library, as well as other audio and video content.
So let's just break down what critical thinking is and what critical thinking is about. Critical thinking is something that we use at every point in our life. That thing that's in our brain that's making us think is actually a critical thinking device, right? So I'm going to explain this in the most basic way, and then we're going to build it up from there. Imagine that you are living in a cave with 7 or 8 other people, and all of a sudden someone, and you haven't got language, right? Language is really limited. You're two pointing and yelling at each other, and that's basically it. And someone comes to the cave, and they have to explain that they want you to come along with them to hunt a mammoth, right? We're talking about the Dark Ages here, a really long time ago. There's a mammoth, and they want you to come and hunt this mammoth. So what language do they need? What do they need to convey to their teammates, to their people in the cave, about what they are going to do to get this mammoth? So first of all, this is what we call the 6 W's. Is it 6 or 7? I always get it wrong. But there's the what. So what are we going to hunt? We're going to hunt a mammal, a mammoth. So what is a mammoth? Who's going to hunt it? Well, we're all going to hunt it because it's a really big thing. And I don't want to hunt it on my own. It's a bit scary, so I don't want to do that. Then why are we hunting it? Well, we're running out of food, and we actually need to make sure that we have food. And these mammoths will present us with enough food for the whole winter, so we need to catch it. Well, okay, we're going to do that, but where is it? So you need to explain where this mammoth is. You also need to explain when you're going to do it. Are you going to do it early in the morning when it's just breaking light? Are you going to do it at night because you know that it can't cope with the dark? And then you've got to explain how you're going to do it as well. So Susie's just highlighted the how. No, actually, that's a really good mistake there to make. No, how is definitely really important when it comes to critical thinking. So how am I going to do this? What am I actually going to achieve when I do this? And how am I going to measure those outcomes? So those 6 W's are really basic questions that are actually part of our inner psyche. They go beyond language, right? They are more important than language. They actually go beyond that because they actually make us human. They help us operate in the world that we are in. So having explained that, you can use those 6 W's to ask questions of the subject matter that you're talking about. So I'm just going to talk a little bit without making it too complicated. With my PhD, I studied what we call a grounded theory. And what that is it's basically conversation analysis. So you get some information by talking to someone and they will say something. And then you look at what they said and you look at it from different angles. And you try and approach it from different angles to try and make more sensible, right? So one of the things that someone to me said was, I don't like using Twitter for the library because each time someone complains that the library toilet is leaking, we jump on it straight away if they do it via Twitter. But if they come to the counter, it could take 2 days before we actually fix the toilet. So their problem with Twitter was that it was actually making the service better, and therefore they didn't like it, right? They'd rather wait for 2 days fixing the toilet than react to it immediately through Twitter. I didn't get that at first. I just got that statement, right? I got the statement, I don't like the library using Twitter because we seem to jump through hoops each time a message comes in. Well, yes, that's the point. That's why it's full. But they didn't see it as useful because they saw it as something that made them jump through the hoop. So that's a really basic way of using critical analysis and critical thinking and actually understanding more about the thing that you've got in front of you. So let's now go back to Alex's explanation of understanding the question. You've got a question, and Alex did a really good job explaining about the what's it called again, the Bloom's taxonomy, right? What does critically analyze mean? What does assess mean? There's a lot of different things there that you can use. They are all really useful ways for you to trigger your thinking on that point. And actually you triggering your thinking on a particular point is what is critical analysis, is what is critical thinking. So one of the examples I always give to students when I deal with them in more detail about, so I don't have time to go all the way through it now, but let's say that, I don't know what your ages are, so I'll pick something that we can all relate to. Let's say you want to buy a house. Whether you buy the house, your parents buy the house, it doesn't matter. You have a list of criteria that you go in for that you want from that house. So it could be that it needs to have a garden and it needs to have parking, but it only needs to have two bedrooms. And you would like the kitchen to be open plan in the living room. Those are criteria. And criteria and critical are very closely linked. They come from the same root. And basically, being critical is applying criteria to something that you're thinking about. So I will answer that in a second, Louisa. But being able to come up with those criteria is a very important part of critical thinking. And you create those criteria by looking at the question and understanding the question and taking that question further. So Louise has asked if reflection is similar to critical thinking. Yes, because reflection is critical analysis of what you've done. So personal reflection is about you reflecting on what you have done. And one of the things that we do in the team, as the skills team, is we reflect on what we do as a team and how we get there and what we can do better as well. So reflection is that sort of critical view of what we are trying to achieve ourselves, as a team, as an organization. Then another good question there, Natasha, different perspectives about critical thinking. Yes, in the sense that, and I don't want to get too philosophical because I could talk about objective, subjective, and all those things, but I don't want to do that. But you need to understand what perspective you are taking. So let's say if you're a nursing student and you're writing about patient care, are you writing from the perspective of the patient? Are you writing from the perspective of the nurse, of the doctor, of the healthcare assistant? And how does that change? So you could actually use those different perspectives to become better at the analysis that you are doing, right? The more perspectives that you put on a problem, it's like the more lights you put on a problem, the clearer the problem becomes, the better you'll be able to unpick it and make it into a sensible description if you want. So yeah, critical thinking is a really important skill, and the one thing that I want you to take away from that little soliloquy, I think is the proper word, is that we all do critical thinking. It's not a scary thing. But you can improve your critical thinking. You can actually develop your critical thinking over time. And part of the university experience is that that is exactly what you do. So the more you develop your critical thinking at university, the more likely you are to get a really high and good grade at the end of it.
That was Dr. Tim Zelstra discussing critical thinking during one of our live workshops. If you want to attend workshops live, go to the University of Derby Libraries website, www.library.derby.ac.uk, and scroll down until you see the link to our workshop calendar. That's all for now. Thank you very much for watching.